Nilikha niya ang langit at lupa. Nilikha niya ang araw at buwan. Nilikha niya ang mga isda at ibon, mga gubat at karagatan. Tunay siyang banal at dakila. Purihin ang kanyang ngalan. Ang lahat ng nilikha niya'y mabuti. Pinagyamanan ng lubusan. Purihin niyo ang Panginoon. Dakilain ang kanyang ngalan. Purihin siya ay awitan at papurihan magpakailanman.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Welcome, dear sisters and brothers, and we gather once again in the house of our Lord so that we could thank and praise our Heavenly Father through our Lord Jesus Christ. We celebrate this Pilgrim's Mass to remind ourselves that we are just journeying here on earth, that we are together in this journey towards Jesus, our Savior. To prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mystery, let us call to mind our sins and beg the Lord's mercy. I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May our loving God have mercy on us, grant us healing and peace, teach us to forgive one another, and bring us all to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. O God, who show the light of your truth to those who go astray, so that they may return to the right path, give all who for the faith they profess are accounted Christians the grace to reject whatever is contrary to the name of Christ and to strive after all that does it honor. To our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated.
A reading from the book of the prophet Micah. Woe to those who plan iniquity and work out evil on their couches. In the morning light, they accomplish it when it lies within their power. They covet fields and seize them, houses, and they take them. They cheat an owner of his house, a man of his inheritance. Therefore, thus says the Lord, behold, I am planning against this race an evil, from which you shall not withdraw your necks, nor shall you walk with head high, for it will be a time of evil. On that day a satire shall be sung over you, and there shall be a plaintive chant. Our ruin is complete, our fields are portioned out among our captors. The fields of my people are measured out, and no one can get them back. Thus you shall have no one to mark out boundaries by lot in assembly of the Lord. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Do not forget the poor, O Lord.
Do not forget the poor, O Lord.
Why, O Lord, do you stand aloof? Why hide in times of distress? Proudly the wicked harass the afflicted, who are caught in the devices the wicked have contrived.
Do not forget the poor, O Lord.
For the wicked man glories in his greed, and the covetous blasphemes sets the Lord at naught. The wicked man boasts, he will not avenge it. There is no God, sums up his thoughts.
Do not forget the poor, O Lord.
His mouth is full of cursing, guile and deceit. Under his tongue are mischief and iniquity. He lurks in ambush near the villages. In hiding, he murders the innocent. His eyes spy upon the fortunate.
Do not forget the poor, O Lord.
You do see, for you behold misery and sorrow, taking them in your hands. On you the unfortunate man depends. Of the fatherless you are the helper.
Do not forget the poor, O Lord. Please all stand.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia. God was in consoling of the world, to himself in Christ is trusting, to use the message of reconciliation. Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A proclamation from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
The Pharisees went out and took counsel against Jesus to put him to death. When Jesus realized this, he withdrew from that place. Many people followed him, and he cured them all. But he warned them not to make him known. This was to fulfill what had been spoken through Isaiah the prophet. Behold, my servant whom I have chosen, my beloved in whom I delight, I shall place my spirit upon him, and he will proclaim justice to the Gentiles. He will not contend or cry out, nor will anyone hear his voice in the streets. A bruised reed he will not break, a smoldering wick he will not quench, until he brings justice to victory, and in his name the Gentiles will hope. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
Good morning po sa inyong lahat and welcome to the Minor Basilica and National Shrine of Jesus Nazareno. Pwede bang pakibati din natin ang bawat isa, good morning. At sabi mo sa kabila, God bless you. At bigyan po natin ng papuri, parangal at pasasalamat ng ating minamahal na Nuestro Padre Jesus Nazareno. Again, just to explain always, our Mass, it is done in English because we call this the Pilgrim's Mass. Especially to consider our international devotees, especially those who are abroad joining us online in this Mass, and we are praying for them, especially those who are sick and those who are taking care of the sick, and also the families of our OFWs, especially our children, grandchildren who were born there already and perhaps are not anymore familiar with Tagalog. And we want them also to grow in their devotion to our dear Jesus Nazareno. That's why we hold this Mass in English, so that more people, especially those who are not in the Philippines, may also know and love, just as we do, our dear Jesus Nazareno. If we will look in our gospel today, entrada pa lang, parang hindi na maganda. Matapos gumawa ng mga mabubuting bagay ang Panginoon, curing the sick, expelling demons, preaching the good news, we are told the Pharisees went out and took counsel against Jesus to put him to death. Ang aga-aga pa lang, kaumpisa pa lang ng Panginoon, gusto na siyang ipapatay ng kanyang mga kalaban. Why? Bakit ganun? Wala namang masamang ginagawa si Jesus Nazareno. Why did his enemies want him dead? They were envious because they did not have powers. They were jealous because they did not have the same popularity. Why did they have ill feelings towards Jesus? It's very simple. In their frame of mind, Jesus was a competitor. Because they were supposed to be the religious leaders, they were supposed to be looked upon by people, and here comes an obscure guy from Nazareth, an unknown village, taking their place. Yun daw ang diferensya sa mga umaway kay Jesus Nazareno. Ang tingin nila sa kanya, kalaban, competitor. Pag ganun daw ang pananaw mo sa buhay, lagi kang miserable, lagi kang busangot, laging negative lagi ang nasa isip. Kapag ang tingin mo sa kapwa mo, kalaban ko to, katunggali ko to, competitor, hindi ka magiging masaya. Kahit na ikaw pa mag number one. Kasi para ka laging pagod. Para ka laging may nahabol. Para ka laging may gustong talunin. And sadly, that has been the operative in this world. Para sa atin, kaya minsan mga magulang, di ba? Oy, pag number one yung anak ko, bibigyan kita ng chocolate, bibigyan kita, anong gusto mong laruan? Pag bababa ka, parusa ka. I'm not saying let us not excel, but in our pursuit for excellence, in our pursuit for success, it is not because the other is a competitor. Kaya nakita nyo po, naghahanda na yung ating mga atleta sa Olympics. Natitiyak ko, hindi yung kalaban nila ang tinitignan nila. Yung sarili nila ang tinitignan nila. Ano pa ba ang dapat baguhin ko, ayusin ko, pagandahin ko pa sa sarili ko? Yun ang mas tama at mas magandang pagtingin. Kung mababa ang grade ko, tignan ko, tataas ko yan kasi gusto kong taasan yung dati kong nagawa. At yun ang makapagbibigay sa atin ng mas magandang fulfillment sa buhay. Hindi tayo natutuwa dahil naungusan natin ng iba. Kay ibang tao, kahit hindi first place, pero dahil nahigitan mo yung sarili mo, masaya ka. Naalala ko po noon, aminin ko sa inyo, nagkapula din ako sa report card. No?
na may pula din ako, no? Hiyang-hiya ako, iyak ako ng iyak, sabi ng mami ko, okay lang yan, pagbutihan mo. Nakaangat naman po ako ng konti, naging itim na the following quarter. Pero sabi ko, mami, mukhang ako pa rin ang kulelat. Pero hindi na pula yung grade ko. Ang iba nga, tinutukso pa rin ako dahil mababa pa rin. Pero sabi ng mami ko, okay lang yan. Ang mas maganda, mas mataas na yung grade mo kaysa dati. Nag-improve ka. And I will not forget that because that became a reminder to me that it is not about competing with others. It is not getting ahead of others. It is improving yourself that matters most. Ang mapabuti tayo lalo. Siguro nga hindi tayo kasing bait ng iba. Hindi tayo kasing husay ng iba. Pero hindi naman po yun ang tinitignan ni Jesus sa sareno eh. Kasi kung yun ang titignan niya, matakot ka na. Kung titignan ngayon ni Jesus sa sareno, sino sa atin dito ang mas magaling magdasal? Ala, baka ikaw ang kulelat. Baka ikaw maiwan. Tatabi kayo kay sister, no? Sabihin, sino ang mas ano? Nako, mahirap yun. Matabi ka kay Mother Teresa. Paano pag sa langit, katabi mo si Padre Pio? Sabihin ni Jesus sa sareno, sino mas mabait kay Padre Pio? Ay, uwian na tayo. Pero hindi ganun tumingin ng Panginoon. Hindi niya tinitignan kung sino ang hinihigitan mong iba. Ang tatanungin niya, dati ganito ka, ano ka ngayon? Dati po, tatamad-tamad ako. Ngayon po, hindi kasing sipag ng iba, pero medyo ngayon noon, mas nagsisimba na ho ako. Dati, kahit Linggo, hindi ako nagsisimba. Ngayon po, hindi po ako araw-araw nagsisimba, pero tuwing Linggo, sinisikap ko po, nagsisimba na po ako. Yun ang paningin ni Jesus sa sareno. Kaya nga siya, kahit maraming umaaway sa kanya, tuloy pa rin ang buhay. Sapagkat ang tingin niya sa kanyang kapwa, hindi kalaban, not competitor, but companion. Hindi kalaban kung hindi kasama. Yun ang ipagdasal natin, mga kapatid. In the first reading, we heard the prophet Micah was denouncing the people. Nag-aaway-aaway, nagdadayaan, naglolokohan. Yun ang resulta pag ang tingin mo sa kapwa mo, kalaban, katunggali. Kaya darating ang panahon, mandadaya ka, mga-away ka, manglalamang ka. Because you look at others as competitors. But if we look at each other as companions, we will not only improve ourselves, we will help one another. Kaya nga ang tawag natin sa misa natin ngayon, Pilgrim's Mass. Lahat tayo naglalakbay. We are all pilgrims. Sinodality nga, di ba yun ang sa simbahan ngayong mga panahon na ito, ang bukang bibig? We are journeying together. We are companions along the way. Kaya nga, si Jesus sa sareno, naging tao, sinamahan tayo. Kasi gusto niyang sabihin sa atin, kasama ko kayo. Hindi ko kayo kalaban. At sana kayo din ituring niyong isa't isa na magkakasama, companions, not competitors. And so, as we continue with this Mass, let us ask ourselves, are we companions to one another? Ang turing ko ba sa kapwa ko, kasama o kalaban? Kalakbay o katunggali? Sapagkat ang tunay na deboto, ang tunay na nanalig kay Jesus sa sareno, ganun ang kanyang nasa isip at puso, tayo'y magkakasama. Perhaps others are better than us. Perhaps others are more accomplished than us. But we need not worry because
the lens of the heart of Jesus is not about who is the best among us, who is the most successful among us. What Jesus looks for are those who strive to be better than their old selves, those who strive to be more like Him, who is our companion along the way.
Please all stand.
Let us turn to God, our merciful Father, who never turns His back on the poor and those in need. Let our response be, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the church may be seen as the home of the weak and the poor, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who hold public office may truly render service to their constituents in the right spirit, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That consecrated persons may dedicate their whole lives to God and to the church through their witness of life, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we may look with compassion and understanding to those who suffer and those who are ill, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the dead may experience the saving power of God, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
In silence, we present our personal intentions. Merciful Father, make us true servants of your love. May we become more and more like your Son, who came to serve and not to be served. This we ask in the name of Jesus our Lord.
Amen. Please be seated.
Lord, here I am. Your call, Lord, here I am to serve and love You. I have led everything just to follow. My heart, here is my mind, here is my soul, here is my home self. I am for You and You alone.
Please all stand.
Pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy church.
Look upon the offerings of the church, O Lord, as she makes her prayer to You. Grant that when consumed by those who believe, they may bring ever greater holiness. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give You thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for just as through Your beloved Son You created the human race, so also through Him with great goodness You form it anew. And so it is right that all Your creatures serve You, all the redeemed praise You, and all Your saints with one heart bless You. Therefore, we too extol You with all the angels, as in joyful celebration we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, Heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Please all kneel.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is a chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Please all stand.
The mystery of faith.
Christ has died, Christ has risen, Christ will come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world. Bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, Jose our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Saint Joseph, her most chaste spouse, and all the apostles and saints, Saint John the Baptist, who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
Let us now pray in the words Jesus taught us.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days. By the help of your mercy, we may always be free from sin, safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, and now you're saying it to all of us here, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you." Lord, do not look on our sins, but look on the faith of your church, and graciously grant our peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other Christ's peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace. Please all kneel.
Behold Jesus Christ, our companion, our Lord and Savior, the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Para sa lahat ng tatanggap ng banal na komunyon, sasagot po tayo ng amen pagkasabi ng pari o ng lay minister ng katawan ni Kristo at isubo agad sa bibig bago umalis sa harapan ng pari o lay minister. Sumunod po tayo.
Umasa ka sa Diyos ang mabuting gawin at manang kang ligtas sa lupain. Sa Diyos mo hanapin ang kaligayahan at pangarap mo ay makakamtan. Ang iyong sarili sa Diyos mo ilagay. Pag nagtiwala'y tutulungan kang ganap. Ang kabutihan mo ay magliliwanag katulad ng araw kung tanghaling tapat. Umasa ka sa Diyos ang mabuting gawin at manahang kang ligtas sa lupain. Sa Diyos mo hanapin ang kaligayahan at pangarap mo ay makakamtan. Sa harap ng Diyos umanatag ka, maging matiyagang maghintay sa Kanya. Huwag mong kaingitan ang gumiginawa sa likong paraan, umunlad man sila. Umasa ka sa Diyos ang mabuting gawin at manahang kang ligtas sa lupain. Sa Diyos mo hanapin ang kaligayahan at pangarap mo ay makakamtan. Ang iyong sarili sa Diyos mo ilagap. Pag nagtiwala'y tutulungan kang ganap. Ang kabutihan mo ay maglilingkod liwanag katulad ng araw kung tanghaling tapat. Umasa ka sa Diyos ang mabuting gawin at manahang kang ligtas sa lupain. Sa Diyos mo hanapin ang kaligayahan at pangarap mo ay makakamtan. At pangarap mo ay
Announcement. Mabibili pa rin po ang opisyal na imahe ni Jesus Nazareno. Ang mga ito po ay mabibili lamang sa ating Parish Finance Office. Maaari na pong mabili ang librong Black Nazarene, Devotion and Discourse. Ito po ay kompilasyon ng mga pag-aaral sa kasaysayan at debosyon sa mahal na poong Jesus Nazareno. Ito po ay nagkakahalaga ng 500 pesos. Ito po ay mabibili lamang sa ating Parish Finance Office. Pagkatapos ng misa, wiwisikan po ang lahat ng banal na tubig. Pinakikiusapan ang lahat na manatili lamang muna sa inyong mga lugar. Tanging sa Quezon Boulevard o sa Plaza San Juan lamang ang labasan ng lahat. Sumunod po tayo. Maraming salamat po sa inyong pagdalaw at pagsisimba sa Basilica Minor at Pambansang Dambana ni Jesus Nazareno. Please all stand.
Let us pray. Having consumed these gifts, we pray, O Lord, that by our participation in this mystery, its saving effects upon us may grow through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Salamat po sa inyong pagpunta dito sa Quiapo in this Pilgrim's Mass. I know marami sa inyo nandito ngayon dahil birthday niyo, anniversary ninyo. Mamaya lapit po kayo sa akin para ma-bless po kayo. Lalo na rin po yung mga galing pa sa mga malalayong lugar, kung galing pang Visayas, Mindanao o sa Norte, lapit din po kayo para ma-bless po kayo at sama-sama tayong magpasalamat at mamintuho sa ating mahal na pong Jesus Nazareno. Thank you for coming at ingat po kayo sa pag-uwi. Thank you din po sa mga naglingkod sa misa. Sa kasalukuyan po, ginaganap ang liturgical congress ng mga naglilingkod sa simbahan. Kaya meron po tayong mga guest na nagsiserve po ngayon galing sa ibang mga parokya para matugunan pa rin ang ating paglilingkod dito sa Quiapo. Kaya maraming salamat po sa inyong pagpunta dito at pagtulong sa Quiapo. Palakpakan natin yung mga guests nating servants, servers ngayong araw na ito. And thank you for all your help and support to the church. Ang mga pamisa, love offerings, online donations, nagdadala dito ng bigas, dilata at iba pang pangayuda. Ang simbahan ng Quiapo ay isa sa mga unang tumutugon kapag may nasusunugan, may mga nasasalanta, may feeding program, and we regularly help parishes and convents which have programs for the poor because our devotion to our Lord Jesus Christ teaches us to be compassionate to one another dahil hindi tayo magkakalaban. Hindi tayo magkakatunggali, tayo'y mga magkakasama. The real blessing of God will come upon us if we look at each other as companions, not competitors on the way to the kingdom. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Blessed are you, O God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, You have given us your only Son to be our way to you. Make us follow him generously, faithfully, and lovingly. Merciful Jesus of Nazareth, you have revealed God's grace and unconditional love for us at the cross. You set your church in this world from which the true light would shine forth for all to see. Grant that we who enter this holy shrine may walk in your ways as disciples of justice, peace, mercy, and hope. We offer our prayers for the sick, the oppressed, the youth, and those in need most of your mercy. Hear our humble petitions. Bless these religious articles that we may be fervent in prayer and charity. As we continue our journey as your pilgrim people here on earth, may we set our hearts on the road to heaven, our true home and reward, where you live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord Jesus by your life.
Thanks be to God.
Padre Jesus Nazareno, sinasamba ka namin, pinipinto ka namin, aral mo ang aming buhay at kaligtasan. Nuestro Padre Jesus Nazareno, iligtas mo kami sa kasalanan. Ang krus mong kinamatayan ay sagisag ng aming kaligtasan. Nuestro Padre Jesus Nazareno, dinarangal ka na amin. Nuestro Padre Jesus Nazareno, dinulwalhati ka namin. Nuestro Padre Jesus Nazareno, dinarangal ka na amin. Nuestro Padre Jesus Nazareno, dinulwalhati ka namin.